So today I wanted to expand on our programming a little bit and kind of build off of what we just learned from Mr. Schiffman and what we learned from code.org. So let's jump into our alpha editor real quick and let's draw something. So I want to draw a simple robot. So I'm going to create a function to draw a robot. Just like I did in code.org, I'm going to write function and then give it a name. So there we go. Now we've got our function called drawRobot. And so what's our robot going to look like? Let's start with a rectangle. And since my canvas is 400 by 400, I'm going to put it in the middle-ish. I'll put it at 200, 200 for my X and Y. And let's go with, I don't know. So, and then if I run this, we will see, hey, where's my robot? Oh, I created the function, but I didn't call the function. So in my draw, I'm going to go ahead and call the function. So now when I run it, why is it yelling at me? Oh, colon, not a semicolon. There we go, fixed it. All right, there's my robot. Actually, let's move him over a little bit. So let's move our X position something like 100. And it's a bit bigger than I want, so let's go 50 by 70. All right, that's a little better. Now, I want to make a robot you may have seen before, so I'm going to give him a round dome on top. To do that, I'm going to use an ellipse. Now, where am I going to center the ellipse? So we know that the top left corner is 100, 200. So I want to center the ellipse on the center of this. So if it's 100 is that and it's 50 wide, that means I need my X coordinate to be 125, right? And then 200, 50, 50. And now if I run that, oh, but I want it to be a dome, not a circle. So how do I do that? I'm going to put the ellipse above the rectangle. So I'm going to cut that. And I'm going to paste it in there. And now I get my nice dome. And then I think if I'm making that very familiar domed robot, that body is way too long. So let's go ahead and make it a little shorter. There we go. I like that better. So far, so good. All right. Now let's jump over to the whiteboard for a second so we can talk about what I just did. So we know we had a rectangle. And the coordinates of this rectangle are 100, 200, right? And I wanted to put an ellipse on here, and I know I wanted the center of it to be right there. So we set the width of this to be 50, which means half of that is 25. So that means the center of my ellipse then is 125, 200. Not so bad, right? And then my ellipse had the same diameter as the width of my rectangle. That's not so bad. So we ended up then with this nice dome shape on the top. All right, so now let's put some little legs on him like that. So how am I gonna do these legs? So these legs are gonna be rects again, right? So I'm going to come in here, and I'll go back to that in a second. Let's think about what is this coordinate going to be. So it's got to be some distance down for the Y and some distance over for the X. So let's make this, how wide should this be? Let's say 10. We can always change it if it's not wide enough. 10 wide. So if this was 100 here, and we've got to move over 10, that means I've got to be at 90, correct? And I've got to be some distance down. So let's do 10 down as well and see what we end up with. All right, so if I want to do my rect again, I'm going to go ahead and do this. That way I know where I am in my code because rect is rect. So I'm going to say rect. So I decided I needed to be over a little bit, so 90. And then I also need to be down, so 210. And then we decided it was 10 wide. And let's go 60 long and see how that looks like and see what that does for us. All right, so maybe a little wider would be better. So let's go 15. And then that means this needs to also get changed, right? So rather than being at 90, we're going to be at 85. There we go, that's better. Doesn't look like it's long enough though, so let's go ahead and make that 70 for the length. All right, now I've got to put one on the other side, so I'm going to put one over here. And again, we want it to be 15 wide, 10 down. So what is this coordinate? Right here, that's what we need to know. So it was 100 plus 50 wide for this big rectangle. So this is going to be 150. And then we just decided that 210 was our Y. And again, 15 and 70. All right, so let's draw our second leg back in our editor. So what do we say? We said 150, comma 210, comma 15, comma 70. Uh-oh, what did I do? Oh, I put a period instead of a comma. So I need to go and fix that. Hey, there we go. So now, gives us the basics. We could add some more embellishments, but that's not what I need to do right now. So what I want to do right now is continue on with what we were working on. This is not the greatest. I get that. You can make your own better than mine. All right, so let's, what if I want more than one robot? If I want more than one robot, if I do another draw robot here, and hit play, I only see one robot. That's because the one robot is being drawn on top of the other robot. So how can we do this? If we had some parameters, like let's say we had a parameter for the X position and the Y position of the robot, I could then say draw this one at 125, 200, and I could say this one at, oh, I don't know, 10 comma 10, and then it would draw them. But if I do this now, nothing's going to change. Why does nothing change? I put my parameters in. Well, I've created these variables, X position and Y position, but I haven't used them. So I got to figure out how I'm going to use these in here. All right, so let's go back to the whiteboard for a second. So we've got our little robot. Now, I want to be generic. I want to be much more generic about this. I'm going to push him off over to the side so we can still see him. And then I need to say, okay, how am I going to dictate the position of my robot? Let's start with the ellipse because it's the first thing we draw. So if I say, here's the ellipse, and this is going to be X pause, comma Y pause for the position of my ellipse. And then I draw my ellipse based on X pause, Y pause. Okay, that's not very elliptical. Let's try that again real quick. Well, it is elliptical, but it's not very circular. That's awful. One more time. There's my circle. Now, still not great, because I want it to be centered on the, there we go, good enough. So we could go back in, and for our ellipse, we could change it so that it's ellipse, X pause, Y pause, 50 comma 50. We could do that. So let's go ahead and see what happens when we do that right now. And we'll get our two different robots. Drawn for us, yeah? Oh wait, I get a circle up here and this robot's still in the same spot. I don't understand. Let's change this. Change this to 50-50 and see what we get. All right, so what I'm getting is only the ellipse is currently referencing X pause and Y pause. So we have to figure out how to make these, the rectangles, also reference that. So now let's go back to the whiteboard. So for the body, I want the body to be like this. Right? So the body is drawn from here. So what are the XY coordinates of this in terms of X pause, Y pause? So we know that The y position is the same. What about the x position? So this x position we already determined over here, this x position is 25 to the left of this x position, right? So right here, this x position is 25 to the left of this x position. We have that right here in our original sketch. So all we do is we say this x position then is x pos minus 25, all right? And then the y pos is just the same because it's the same y position. So let's jump over and make that change in our code. So over here, we go x pos minus 25. And then here, the y coordinate of the body rectangle is y pos. All right, so let's see what happens when we run that. Hey, look at that. Now we have our new position for our body. Now we just got to figure out the same thing for our legs. All right, so let's go back to our sketch, our original sketch. We know that to get from here all the way over to here is 25. Oh, and we changed it, right? Because we decided 10 was too little. So these are 15. 15. So we decided that was the case. So 25 plus 15. All right, so to make the legs, we are going to need 25 plus 15, to move over from here over to here, right? So this coordinate is going to be 25 plus 15, right? So I could actually go x pos minus, what's 25 plus 15? Come on, calculator, 30, 40. So x pos minus 40, comma. And now we've got to move down. How far did we move down? On our picture, we moved down 10, even though I just scribbled it out and made it 15. So this is actually going to be y pos plus 10. All right, so let's take a look at that code. So I come back over here, and for this leg, I go x pos minus 40, y pos plus 10. And now when I run that, hey look, now I've got my other leg, my leg. How do I get my second leg? I've got to do the same thing. So I'm lazy. Well, you know what, I'm not going to do something. I was about to do something really bad, and I'm not going to do it. So let's think about it real quick. So this is going to be x pos. And now I've got to add some distance. And now I've just got to get to the edge of the rectangle. So that's just half of the width of the rectangle, 25. And we know our y pos is exactly the same for both legs because they're the same distance down. Look at that. Now I've got my two robots. So I could add a third robot. A new location. Whoop! Let's move them further over. I don't like them right on top of each other. So I can now draw as many robots as I want simply by changing the x and y position of the robot. So what I want you to do is I want you to create a robot function. You probably ought to go in and add some comments. So like here you can see I added the legs, and again to add comments all you do is the double slash, and you can type in what it is that you're doing. So that's going to be the head, and then it'll come down and I'll go. That way later on when you're going back and you're looking at your code, it makes it easier to understand what's going on. So before I leave this video, I want to mention a couple of things that I have done to make life easier later. So first thing is when I named my function drawRobot, it tells you exactly what it's going to do. So when you name a function, you should name it in a name that actually means something in plain English. I could have called it Bob. I could have just said, this is Bob. And then each of these up here are Bob. And it would have worked. I don't want to do that though, because I don't want to have to remember later that Bob meant draw the robot. Makes sense, right? And if I'm putting two words together, a convention that is often used is called camel case. is to make the second word uppercase and the first word lowercase. So here you can see our function starts with draw robot, and this was the same convention that code.org used in all of their function creation. Very standard convention. Then for the x and y position of the robot, I call them xpos and ypos for x position, y position. That way, again, later on when I go back and I look at it, it makes it easy to read and understand what's happening. And then you'll notice in my code, I've got xpos, comma, space, ypos, comma, space. You don't need these spaces in there, okay? I could compress this all together. Oh, not that way, can't get rid of the five. I could compress this all together and it would run just as well. Let me show you that. See, doesn't make a change. But what it does is it makes it easier to read when I put a little space in after my commas, all right? Makes it easier to read by humans. The computer doesn't care. In fact, I could put in as much space as I want and the computer don't care. It's still gonna run. I don't do that because I wanna make sure that this is easy to read. And to make it easy to read, I do that. Same thing when I do math. So when I'm taking 25 away, I space it out to make it easy to read, all right? So just a couple other conventions I wanted to draw your attention to. So what I want you to do is I want you to draw your own robot, all right? Simple robot. Make it a little bit more complex than the one I just drew, and make it so that you've got parameters for the X and Y position at a minimum. You can also do color. So add some color to your robot. Change some of the fill to the stroke, to the different body parts. Make it look a little much cooler than mine. And then again, have some parameters that include at least the X and Y position. You can have other parameters for color if you want them. And see how you do.